planning for this year's episodes, me and Miley got a gut feeling that we are going to dedicate this year's episodes to gut health. Your gut can easily compete to Table Mountain's diverse flora and fauna. While hiking Table Mountain's southeast facing slopes, you will find yourself in thick indigenous forest. On the other hand, when you are hiking the north face of the same mountain, you will find no single tree and the fynbos is at your knees, and this is because of different climates and rainfall. Looking deep into your gut, there are trillions of bacteria helping you digest your meals, making essential nutrients that you can't produce on your own, and protecting you from disease. The gut microbiome is just like Table Mountain, a vast ecosystem of organisms, such as bacteria, yeast, viruses, and protozoans living in our digestive pipes. These organisms collectively weigh up to 2 kilograms, basically heavier than an average brain. It is increasingly treated by scientists as an organ in its own right. Unfortunately, in this rat race we are living, there are a lot of factors influencing our guts negatively. For instance, not eating a wide range of foods, smoking, drinking too much alcohol, a lack of prebiotics, lack of sleep, too much stress, and the use of antibiotics. It takes up to 6 months to restore your microflora in your gut to a healthy state after antibiotic treatment.
The question we would like to answer with this short video is, why do we have to look after our family's guts? Some might think that the only reason is not to feel bloated and uncomfortable, especially when going to the loo. But studies have linked gut health to many diseases that has nothing to do with the digestive tract. Let me discuss a few. Did you know that your gut is your biggest immunity organ? Harmful bacteria that enters our bodies through the digestive tract needs to be disarmed by, among others, the acid in our stomach and the good bacteria in the digestive tract. If the balance between the good and the bad bacteria is off, the bad bacteria takes over, wins the war, and causes illness. The most obvious sign would be an upset stomach, but in the background, a lot more is going on. Your overall level of inflammation in your body increases. And inflammation is one of the biggest causes of chronic diseases like heart disease, diabetes, gout, arthritis, just to mention a few. Your gut also influences your mood. 95% of serotonin, the happy hormone, is formed in the gut. If your gut is not healthy, serotonin levels drop, and this has been associated with depression, anxiety, eating disorders, PMS, and even obesity. Let's look at asthma and allergies. Have you ever wondered how asthma, that involves the lungs, could be caused by something in your diet that has nothing to do with your lungs? Well, the lining of your gut provides a barrier between the outside environment and the inside of your body. Small digested particles can cross this barrier and enter the bloodstream. But if the balance in the gut is not right, larger undigested particles can also cross this barrier into the bloodstream. Your immune system recognizes these as foreign objects and launch an attack. This can trigger an allergic reaction, which can show in the lungs, in the skin, and many different systems in the body. So, if you want to reduce your family's risk of developing chronic diseases and allergies, and you want to improve their immunity and their mood, make gut health a priority in your house.
Stay tuned for the next few episodes on tips how to look after your family's guts. After all, a happy gut means
a happy you!